Welcome everybody to my channel. This is Marky Park. Today is Friday, January the 5th, and I am in the Magic Kingdom parking lot today. My only goal tonight, it's a little bit after 4 p.m. I'm going to go over to the Country Bear Jamboree because the rumors are online that they're going to close it for some refurbishment. Not closing it for good, it sounds like, but it sounds like they're going to add some new music and things like that. So we're going to head over there and try to get that in the video today for posterity's sake. So there'll always be a version of it somewhere online. So join me tonight as I go into the Magic Kingdom. And I forgot to mention I brought my brand new Loungefly bag. This is the Return of the Jedi end scenes, so you've got a lot of glare. So here you go, R2 and Wicket. You got Luke dueling his father, and then the Emperor. More Ewoks. You got Boba Fett, and then on the back you have Jabba the Hutt. The trams are running at the Magic Kingdom. All right, so we're in the Magic Kingdom parking lot. It is almost 4:15 p.m. on Friday. I've got my Magic Kingdom statue hat, 50th anniversary of the Magic Kingdom, Walt Disney World. Underneath my jacket here, and my Walt Disney World shirt. On the back, I've got all the attractions at the Walt Disney World, and I'll put that in right here so you can see it. I took a picture of it earlier. And I have my new Run Disney jacket that I found at the thrift store yesterday. It's about 70 degrees outside with a little bit of wind, so this is like a windbreaker, so I think this will be appropriate for tonight. I don't know how late I'm going to be here. As we pass the blue tram. Captain Hook. I'm parked in Ursula. Highly recommend if you come out to Walt Disney World Parks, use the My Disney Experience app on your phone and use that car locator on the app, because they haven't seen any of my other videos already. These parking lots are massive and you can easily get lost out here if you haven't traveled to the parking lot often, many times before. So I highly recommend that car locator. It's very, very helpful, especially at night when it's not as bright as it is right now. I mean, it's overcast, but definitely can see really well here. Parking lot just keeps going back and back.
and forward. I'm actually near the back because I got here late in the afternoon. But just on a side note, while I'm walking to the ticketing and transportation center here at the Magic Kingdom, when I was coming in to the parking lot, when I pulled up to the gate, I pulled up and they just asked, "Are you an annual pass holder?" And I say, "Yes." And they said, "Oh, you're good to go then." And I'm like, "Oh, thanks." Usually I have to scan my magic band to get the free, you know, get my parking. But I think my band actually lit up because I've got the Magic Band Plus that has the lights on it. I think it actually lit up when I pulled up to that spot, so maybe that's something new. But that's the first time I haven't had to scan my magic band to get into a parking lot. Alright, we're getting close to the monorail, and there's Heavy Metal Mickey. So, I haven't decided yet where I'm going to have dinner, but I think I have a gift card from Christmas. And I think I'm going to use that inside the park today. Maybe go to Casey's Corner, see if there's any specialty items. I honestly don't know if the holidays have actually ended here at the Magic Kingdom. I saw some decorations at the parking lot entrance still. There were some Christmas wreaths. So I'm thinking there might actually be some holiday items still available. So we'll see what's available here when I get inside the park. Alright, so I just went through security. I actually got stopped and they checked my bag. Apparently, he said the eyeglass case in my backpack actually set off the alarm. So who knew? Glasses. I can never get these things straight. Alright, so I'm gonna hop on the monorail here to get to Magic Kingdom. Last time I took the ferry boat, and it was about 25 minutes to get to the park. We've got Monorail Gold. Monorail Gold today. Monorail Gold today.
Alejado de las cuestas. Mommy, did I say? Yes, Daddy. Did I say?
just by looking at the roof, it looks like I need to paint, new paint job, maybe. Going to the main contemporary building. There you go. You got Chef Mickey's right down there.
They have Chef Mickey here, where they
Chef
let
Mickey comes out.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Fly right by. Shops down below. They still have the gingerbread house. Still got Christmas decorations. There's a new Bay Lake Tower here.
I'm sure, yeah.
Still a lot of nature out here. A lot of trees across the other side of the lake there. A lot of trees here too. First thing we see here, Space Mountain. Tron right behind it. Tried getting the retro queue at 7 a.m. this morning for Tron Light Cycle, and right at the 7 a.m. mark, I hit the join button and it was already booked. Solid. No Tron today. That's okay. Been on a couple times. It is a really fun ride, though.
That makes sense.
And I'm a really big fan of Tron. Both movies. I'm definitely one of the users. Tron user. If you know, you know. So yeah, the Christmas tree is definitely still up. Yep, we still got holiday decorations, so I think those must be up until next week.
Alright, are we going to the train or are we going to the
train house? Alright, and we're here, pulling into the station.
What time is our
5:40.
Okay. Alright, Passholder line over here. They got some Mickey Mini topiaries. Thank you. And we're in. So I think I'm going to look at doing a mobile order for Casey's Corner. So I'm going to take a look at the menu here. So did the mobile order at Casey's Corner, only waited probably less than 5 minutes. So I got this Chipotle barbecue footlong dog, came with a side of fries, and I ordered a Minute Maid lemonade sugar-free, zero sugar. I'm gonna try this out and see how it goes. Piano player next to me, so it's really loud, but I'll try to speak up. So it's all beef hot dog, which is delicious. Try to grab a bite of the actual flavors. There's a lot going on in this hot dog. Pulled pork, coleslaw, Chipotle barbecue. From what I've had so far, it's delicious. But it's kind of messy. I say thumbs up. So over by Casey's Corner, they actually have some complimentary water out here on the tables outside. So I don't know. Is this like a normal thing to have the water out here?
Yes.
Awesome.
Good to know.
So yeah, if you're ever over at Casey's Corner when it's nice and hot out in the summer, come over here, right next to the piano, and get yourself a complimentary water. Alright, so we're at the Country Bear Jamboree inside, waiting for the theater to open. You see all the bear artwork. More portraits on the wall here. Hopefully all this stays up. This is the entrance here. We got Big Al on the wall there. Got on the other side there. Got your piano player. We're just waiting for the doors to open for the show to begin. So I'm waiting for the Country Bear Jamboree. I'm just kind of looking at wait times in the park right now. It's 5:30 in the evening, and everything's pretty busy. It looks like the longest wait time is Seven Dwarfs Mine Train. It's like 2 hours on the app. Don't know if I'm going to do any rides tonight. Gohan Magic is 15 minutes. The shortest wait times here. 60 minutes for the Haunted Mansion. Thunder Mountain is 85 minutes. Even to get on the railroad is 30 minutes. Jungle Cruise is 95 minutes. Yeah, it's pretty busy on a Friday night. Carousel Progress, only 5 minutes. Space Mountain's 85 minutes. Yikes.
Thank you.
One night I left the wife at home, went out with the boys. I was acting like a drunk one and making a lot of noise. The little girl called my hand. I said, I can't, I'm a married man. She said, she ain't gonna steal, you better not prowl. Don't do snow with the go-go. If you can't bite, don't growl. If you can't bite, don't growl.
And now, a heart rendering ditty by our own growler of song, Liver Lips McGraw. Sing it, Mac.
I've got a woman, she's got me. Whatever we do, we both agree. She ain't pretty, but I ain't too. The things we like are the things we do. A woman ain't pretty, but she don't swear none. She's kinda heavy, don't weigh a ton. She's my woman through and through. I love her only cause the heart is true.
Right up.
Country Bear Jamboree. It's a classic. Hopefully they don't change too much of the show, because it's been here since the opening of the park October 1st of 1971. So it's, I mean, yeah, it's over 50 years old, but it's a classic. It's still entertaining. It might be a little outdated, but it's a hand clapper. I'll just say that. So, right next to Country Bear Jamboree, we've got Tiana's Bayou Adventure under construction here. The former Splash Mountain. And kind of zoom in here. They've got some, looks like some flowers installed there at the top. I don't know if you can see it very well. There we go. We've got some flowers up there. They have the water tower. Let's see if we can get a better angle of it there. There you go. Tiana's Foods. So, it's like progress is happening. I've heard online that this is going to be opened probably in the fall of this year, but definitely by the end of the year, it looks like. I don't know. It looks very beautiful. All this, the plant life they've added. I mean, it's probably fake plants, but actually, there's real plants growing up here. Just get an idea of the crowd levels here. This is the line for Big Thunder Mountain. Yeah, there's the end of the line over there. So yeah, don't think I'm going to be going on any rides tonight. Like I said, I didn't have any other plans other than going to a Country Bear Jamboree. And I had a delicious dinner at Casey's Corner too. But you know what? I might go check out the train station here. I might be able to catch a ride on the train. I haven't done the railroad here in forever. So we're going to head up there. That's what all these people up here are waiting for. Waiting for the railroad. We're here, so I might as well go do it. Walt Disney World Magic Kingdom Railroad Station here. The train just pulled up. And everybody's getting off the train, and we're going to get on here in just a minute. There you go. There's your announcement. The Walt Disney World Railroad now loading for a scenic trip around the Magic Kingdom. This is a little waiting room here. Up on the schedule board here, it says Tucson. Conductor over here taking tickets. You can only see this car here. What's 34? 34? Look. So hopefully, we'll get a seat. Might have to take a horse. sit in the caboose. Let's see, it's here. Sun's starting to go down. Yep. Right next to Splash Mountain here. It's going to be Tiana's Bayou Adventure.
Parties of two or three will be sharing a row. Parties of two or three will be sharing a row.
Okay. The queue line? Oh, that's cool. So let me zoom in here so you can kind of see. There is a mural on the wall here. Looks like a alligator playing a trumpet, maybe? Try to move it around a little bit. This is the part of the Tiana's Bayou Adventure. That's over here on the left. I think this is the queue line down here for the Tiana ride. It's getting dark, it's kind of hard to see. And yeah, here's the train station.
Front of the second car.
Thank you.
This might be the only ride they actually do tonight, because it's just really busy. I really don't want to stand in line for 60 plus hour or 60 plus minutes.
How old? Quantos años? Six. Can I have him on the middle and then dad on the outside? Thank you.
That was nice. I like the lanterns they've got here. They look like all the like gas lanterns or oil lanterns maybe. I like all the old timey stuff. The other reason why I'm probably not gonna do much more here at the park is that my battery, my phone's running low. I do have
If you're just joining us, a hearty welcome aboard.
I do have a power bank, but I don't think I brought the cord for it. So here we go.
Everybody stay seated and keep your hands and arms, feet and legs safely inside the train. And as always, keep an eye on your little ones.
Para su seguridad, permanezca sentado y mantenga las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del tren. Y cuide a los pequeños. Gracias.
Those of you who've been riding with me for a spell already know how much I love minding this railroad. But for those times I'm fixing for something a bit wilder, Big Thunder Mountain.
Something tells me this is probably Walt's favorite ride in Disneyland. It's probably the railroad. We get a behind the scenes look at the Big Thunder Mountain. Canyon for gold in there. Got some donk, got some mules. There's some javelinas down there. Now we see those in Tucson. Oh yeah, I definitely see rattlesnakes. I had to get rid of a rattlesnake at our house in Tucson once. And you got the river. Going across the river. Maybe the Great Mississippi.
The change in scenery means we've left the rattle and rumble of that old gold mine behind and entered my favorite leg of the
little guy on the river there.
Wilderness, calm waters, and untamed beauty.
Yeah, folks, sun's setting, so it's kind of hard to see some of this stuff here.
Just think of the extraordinary things
to Native Americans here.
Hiking trails, bird calls, fireflies, and starry
some deer.
Nights. Setting out for adventure at sunrise and telling the tale around a campfire that night. Considering how wonderful things are out here, I'm fortunate that some of my closest friends are at home.
Well, here we are.
That village is a truly special
village there.
Johnson into the forest. The enchanted forest of
fantasy. Yeah, I was zoomed in a little bit.
Where magic.
Listen.
Hear that?
Peter Pan? Peter Pan's on top of the train.
Hey! Get back here, Shadow!
Oh, he's trying to catch a shadow.
We really must find some stronger things.
Told you it's enchanted, and not just the forest. From the tips of castle spires to the sands under the sea, magic and happily ever afters await around every corner in Fantasyland.
Yeah, there's not much to see. It's getting dark. Going under a bridge.
Or join Goofy in his stunt plane for some airborne acrobatics. This station is also the gateway to the rest of Fantasyland and Tomorrowland.
At least he has some commentary.
Please wait until the train has come to a complete stop. Gather your juggling pins, unicycles, and other belongings, and carry your strollers away from the platform before unfolding. That way, we can start loading up for the next leg of our trip. For those disembarking, please watch your step, and thanks for traveling.
Complete stop. You hear a single whistle, and I give you the all clear. Once again, remain fully seated to hear that single whistle, and the words all clear. Remain seated, please.
I think we're gonna get off here just because it looks like there's a lot of people that want to ride the train. That was fun though.
Remain seated. All clear, my friends. Welcome to Fantasyland Station. This will also be your stop for nice Tomorrowland and Tron.
Nice. Okay. Yeah, you see Tron over here. I don't actually come back to Fantasyland very often, at least not all the way back to the circus. Oh, that's where we're at here. You got the circus tents. We'll walk by the banners here. The ballerina on the big top. The hippo. The lion. World's most amazing circus. Humphrey, the unicycling bear. We got Salty the Seal, Symphony of the Seas. Yeah, we don't usually come down this way. This is something a little different. So yeah, this is a little bit like Disneyland's Toontown, if you want to compare it to something else Disney related. So yeah, this is just a little play area for your kids. You got Casey Jr. here. Got some restrooms over there by the station. You got Goofy's Barnstormer. It's a little roller coaster ride. You got, up this way, you've got Dumbo, the Dumbo ride. There's two of them, but it looks like only one of them is running right now. I wonder if we can go to Tomorrowland this way. I think this is just the Barnstormer. Go around this way. So this is the entryway here for the circus. Yeah, the sun's setting, so it's going to be hard to see anything here. Yeah, there's Dumbo on this side over here. Akimbo. The circus here. Yeah, big top souvenirs. See the castle in the distance here. You smell the popcorn in here, it smells delicious. But I ate that footlong hot dog. Oh, there's the mine train right here. Let's see if we can see it coming by here. There you go. It's a little dark, but you can see it coming going by. That was a 2-hour wait when I looked on the app earlier. Everything is pretty much 45 minutes or longer. Most of the rides are probably an hour or more, the bigger attractions. So over to my left here is, if you can hear the motors, is the Tomorrowland Speedway. And right in front of us here is Mad Tea Party. I don't think they're on this side of the ride, but at the Mad Tea Party, there's a couple statues. There's a Cheshire Cat and the Mad Hatter. And those are interactive with the Magic Band Plus. Or maybe even just the regular Magic Band. If you wave your band in front of those statues, they'll actually interact and they'll talk or do they'll say something, basically. I think most of them are still active. Some of them even had some Christmas speech. Let's see if I can find one of them. But there's definitely a couple of them here. I see them. So these statues, they were put up in 2021 for the 50th anniversary of Walt Disney World. So there were 50 statues spread out between the four parks. So the first one over here actually is the Cheshire Cat, but the last time I was here I couldn't get him to do anything. So see, my band just lit up, so that means I'm near one of the statues. So let's see if the cat will say anything. But he's not interacting. The Mad Hatter, I'm pretty sure, is still active here, so he's right here. See if the band lights up.
Delightful!
There you go.
Absolutely delightful, wouldn't you say?
So interesting that the Cheshire Cat doesn't work, but the Mad Hatter does. I have no idea why. But yeah, those are pretty cool. They're spread out. There's a lot of them actually over by Walt's statue. They kind of circle his statue. A lot of like the legacy characters like Mickey, Minnie, Donald, Goofy. I think all of those are over there by Walt. And then there's others spread out. I think Animal Kingdom might have the least number. I think there's only like 3 or 4 statues there. I think there's a Bambi and a Thumper. Maybe Simba. Timon and Pumbaa maybe. I can't remember for sure. But there aren't that many over at that park. So in the distance here behind the speedway is the Tron Light Cycles. There's a Tomorrowland Speedway right here. Seems very busy over here. You usually don't see long waits for the Tomorrowland Speedway. Usually it's a walk-on ride during the day. Last time I was here, I just walked right on. At the beginning of the day, it's a 45-minute wait. That kind of gives you an idea how busy the park is when the rides that have the lowest wait times are kind of high. I'm gonna walk over by Space Mountain maybe before I head towards the exits here. People mover just up above there. That's actually a fun one to cut. Whoop. Yeah, it's definitely crowded. Almost got run over. I like the lights up here on the... it used to be an astral orbiter or something up there. Rockets.
You want to get on?
People mover is probably not very long wait, but it's probably like 15, 20 minutes, I would guess, probably. Let's see if we can see if there's any lines over there. Yeah. So it's only 6:15 p.m. But as you can see by the crowd, it's very busy on a Friday night, which can be expected. It's the beginning of the weekend. Everybody's getting off of work, all the locals. So, I don't think I'm going to get on any more rides today. I just passed Space Mountain. It said 95 minutes. They actually have roped off queue lines on the outside, which you usually don't see during the day. So, again, this was just a kind of an impromptu visit. With no special plans. I did want to go to the Country Bear Jamboree. I accomplished that. We got to see a little country hoedown before I went into the Jamboree, so that was pretty cool. Got to see a cavalcade parade. Got to see the people mover. They still have Christmas decorations. You can see the lights underneath the buildings here, red and green. And gotta say, really missing Stitch's Great Escape, and this is all that's really left of it here. They painted over the walls. This is where that ride used to be. Stitch has a special place in my heart because that was the first movie that I took my son to see at the drive-in theater. And I think he was only probably like all of 2 years old, maybe. 2 years old. I took him to his first Disney movie at the drive-in. It was Lilo and Stitch. So, just kind of sad to see that they never did anything with that particular ride. It's been closed for several years now. And you see the castle here. So I think on my way out, I'm going to make one more stop as we exit Tomorrowland. I'm going to probably get a Joffrey's on the way out, enjoy a monorail ride or a ferry boat ride, and head home for the night. So if you enjoy these videos, please hit that like button, share with your friends. I try to give little tips here and there to help others that maybe haven't visited the Walt Disney World parks, or maybe have, it's been a while. So just kind of throw my two cents in there where I can. I consider myself a Diz nerd. I've been going to the park since I was 11, I think, the first time I visited. So, if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please. Trying to grow the channel and bring more content. And we'd like to hear from all of you out there. In YouTube land, leave a comment as we pass by this photo op here for season's greetings. Probably here for another week. So until then, this is Marky Park. We'll see you next time. One last visit to Christmas.
at the Magic Kingdom in 2023-2024 Christmas season, I guess 2023. Lots of people in line getting pictures. Lots of people getting ready for parades. Weaving in and out of traffic. Getting closer to the tree. My wife and I actually watched an old video, home movie, I would say, that's on YouTube, circa 1971-72, and got to see the Christmas tree back then. It looked like they had a real Christmas tree back in the early 70s, which definitely looked real. Now, this one is definitely not a real tree, but it's real tall. Way taller than the one that they had back in the old times, back in the original park days, early 70s. But yeah, here we go. Beautiful. We got some presents that haven't been opened still up down at the bottom of the tree. We need to open those presents up here pretty soon, or Santa's gonna take them back.
Alright, so I made one more stop here. I'm at the Contemporary Resort. We're gonna go see if we can see the gingerbread house here. Make sure I don't trip the escalator here. There's a little security line here. I think that's to get onto the monorail. Grand Canyon mural here. Fantasia is one of the shops here. Another shop here. And I think we gotta go this way if we wanna go see the gingerbread house. There's an artist over there. Do some caricatures. Some really neat artwork here on the walls here. I think this is the Fantasia shop. Really cool. Mickey neon. Here we go. Met is a gingerbread house. It's got a... That's got the Disney 100 logo on it. Let's go take a look at the sign here. Let's see what it says up here. Disney's Contemporary Resort Gingerbread. Cinderella Castle, Disney 100th Anniversary Celebration Gingerbread. Mary Blair inspired, designed by Walt Disney Imagineers. 12 days to assemble. 67 pounds of modeling chocolate, 88 pounds of rolled fondant, 512 eggs, over 4,000 castle gingerbread bricks by 40 bakery cast, and last but not least, 12 sprinklings of magical pixie dust. Pretty amazing. As we see the monorail go by. What a way to end the video. Look at that. There is the monorail, and there is the gingerbread house. Awesome.
To any grams who did not make this trip, this is our bread trip right next to us. We'll be making a U-turn and coming to pick you guys up.
For your safety, remain seated with the doors closed, keeping your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside while the tram is moving.
One last ride for the evening.
Thank you.
So a little quick tip. Looks like all the trams are running at the Walt Disney World parks. So after a really long day of walking, I recommend if you're in the parking lot, take one of these trams out to your vehicle.
Alrighty,
it's kind of a fun little ride to end the night.
Drivers up front and myself here on the back of the train. We hope you had a magical day here at the Magic Kingdom. Just stay safe and managed as we are headed out towards your cars. If you have any car issues tonight, like your car has disappeared, please have disappeared, or just does not feel like starting, please flag down a white SUV with yellow and green lights on top for a parking pass number, and would be more than happy to assist you. There are large materials laying on the ground to stay in the direction of the one and only exit. And the speed limit on the parking lot is 15 miles an hour. That is 15.5 miles an hour. We'll go on board. We'll make it 2 stops and 2 stops only. Our first stop is going to be the back of the parking lot. For any friends in Scarlet or Ursula, then we're going to make a U-turn, head back up here, and drop off for any friends in Scarlet or Ursula.
We're in Ursula. So we're the first stop. There goes the monorail.
Alrighty, friends, if you're parked in Spark or Captain Hook, you can go and look for your car. Give it a big wave. We are going to return here in just a few short moments. We're just going to drop our friends off in the back lot once again before we come back up here. When we make our stop, we're going to have Ursula to the driver's right hand side and Carol will be to the driver's left. When you guys do see the tram,
just
please carry all the lines to the other side of the orange poles and purple poles before setting any strollers up. This is an active tram lane. There are other trams and other vehicles around us, so it is safest for you and the rest of your party on the other side of the orange and purple poles.
Just past Captain Hook.
We are so prone to that
panic
accelerating and braking, so please remain fully seated, holding on to all loose items till we complete our stop. Once again, we complete our stop. We're going to have Ursula to the driver's right-hand side, Carla to the driver's left.
Hello.
Alrighty, Benson, there is our stop.